Hello, and today we are with Mr. Roland Svensson, who is the General Manager of the FLC Grand Halong here in Vietnam. Good afternoon to you, Roland.
Good afternoon, Stephen.
It's wonderful to see you again. Now, yeah. I must say, the hotel has only been open, I think it's a week, is it?
It's about a week that's really been in full operations.
Well, I have to say, I feel a little bit sorry for you, because most general managers would not want a major ministerial governmental conference to take place within that first week of opening. We've also had the ASEAN Tourism Forum, which means you've had the TRAVEX component as well as the ministers. How has this first week been for you?
Well, as you say, you know, it's probably been not the kind of dream event. But at the same time, it's because of having this, we have to put a lot of effort into planning and preparing for the opening. Obviously, you have the ministers from all the ASEAN countries here. You have the professionals or the colleagues. So you know that you have to be at your best. You cannot hide around a corner when you do this kind of event. So it's been a lot of planning, it's been a lot of preparation, and I must say it's been very successful. The feedback from both the ministers and from the business professionals and everything has been very good. It's been I would say not a couple of hours and then it's over, but it's been a good success. It's been a good success for us.
You've opened plenty of hotels. A lot of hoteliers would prefer to do a soft opening, give themselves 6 months before they had an event like this. Have there been any surprises that you've come across in this week, considering you have got a lot of VIPs here?
Well, I mean, when you do something like this, you obviously deal directly also with the government. The Vietnamese government, and there are a lot of changes. There's a lot of last minute that always happens that you're not really prepared for. There are a lot of last minute requests from the ministerials, from countries and so forth. So you have to be prepared. You have to know that you have to have a plan B. You have to have a backup for last minute requests, etc. So that is something which probably, because I've been involved with ATF and attended ATF for over 10 years, so with that experience, I was able to plan it, the plan B. But apart from that, it's been pretty smooth. Vietnam government are very organized. We planned this now for six months, and it's been so. I think it's gone according to the script, I would say. Pretty much.
Now, the FLC Grand Halong is the most luxurious hotel here in Halong,
That's
Vietnam.
Right.
Tell us about the property. What makes this property special, and how have you split up the rooms that you have here?
I mean, the first thing with this property is obviously the location. I mean, we sit on the top of a hill overlooking Halong Bay, which is one of the seven wonders of the world, with the view, half of the hotel, of the 650 rooms, are actually overlooking the Halong Bay. So it's probably one of the most spectacular views, and I would say almost in the world. Halong Bay is so special. So that I would say is one of the main features, and that's the feedback we get from everybody who comes here. But the property in itself, I think the style and how it's been designed, and having the world-class golf course wrapped around the hotel, an amazing convention center. So I think with that, it's a very unique hotel. In terms of the rooms, it's quite a unique setup. Is that from the fourth floor up to, it's got 20 floors altogether. So from the fourth floor up to the 12th floor, we basically have one category, it's deluxe rooms. One facing the Halong Bay, the other one facing the golf course. From the 14th floor up to the 19th floor, it's all two-bedroom suites. So, and very, very, very spectacular suites. So we have that on the top floor with an executive floor, etc. So all the suites are kind of combined into one block on the top, and then the presidential suite. And then on the top of the hotel on 20th floor, we have a sky lounge, which with a spectacular view of Halong Bay. So that's kind of how it's grouped and how it's set up.
Is the sky lounge that you mentioned there, is that the executive lounge? You have an executive floor.
We have an executive floor. It's not the sky lounge in itself covers the entire building. as you can see already, Stephen, I mean, it's quite a long building. So the sky lounge stretches from one side to the other side. Both sides has an outdoor balcony area, and then in the middle we have the sky lounge. The sky lounge is not open yet in full, so we're actually still working a little bit on the concept, but it's going to be very unique. And on the other side of the building, we have a view of the golf course, and as I said, it's a very spectacular golf course, obviously with the backdrop of Halong Bay. So either if you stay at the golf bay view, or if you stay at the Halong Bay view, you have a very unique view. So nobody can really complain to say, well, I'm staying in the back of the hotel, this is not a nice room with the view. So we have that advantage.
The skyline sounds absolutely amazing. You said it's not quite open yet. When are you scheduled to open it?
Probably in the next couple of months. We had one concept which we were ready to go with, but then later on we thought it wasn't really, we want to do something world class because of the view. We want to do something which is, you know, not just a bar, but we're working on a concept now that it's going to be very 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 unique. So once it's all finished, I'll let you know, and you will see it's going to be something very special, nothing that Vietnam has seen before.
Now, of course, this week has been quite particular. After this week is finished, who's going to be taking up these over 600 rooms that you have here? Where are the markets? Where do you anticipate your guests coming from?
I think it's going to be a split 50-50 between domestic and international, for sure. Very recently, just a couple of months ago, they opened up the new highway, which I think you experienced when you came, Stephen, which now cuts down the time from Hanoi to Halong to about 2 hours. Previously, it was almost 5 hours. So that has helped us quite a lot, which means that we will get quite a lot of domestic business, especially from Hanoi coming. They also just recently opened an international Wundong airport. So we will start getting domestic flights from, say, Saigon, for example. But also the plans are from neighboring countries, Taiwan, China, Bangkok, Singapore. So I think there should be a good split 50-50 between the two. In terms of market segments, as I mentioned, we have an amazing convention center where the ministerial meetings are being held. And together with that, with the hotel, with the outlets, with the golf course, I think the MICE business is going to be very attractive. And with the combination of having Hanoi so close, as we know, very often MICE business, they want to do maybe 1 or 2 days in Hanoi, pre or post, and then come here for the meetings. So I believe the MICE business will be something big. Last but not least, Halong is on every single plan when you come to Vietnam. You have to come to Halong. There's, you know, and Vietnam is still, for the international travelers, Vietnam is still very much round trip. You know, people come to Vietnam, it's not so much like Thailand, where people nowadays, they come only to Bangkok, or they come to Phuket or Samui, because Vietnam is more, you have to visit Hanoi, Saigon, Hue, maybe Hoi An, and Halong. It's on everybody's kind of itinerary. So, and previously he was coming to Halong, you did the cruises, and then you went back. Now with a luxury five-star hotel we have, we probably can kind of do a lot of combinations of people going out, seeing the Halong Bay on the cruises, and at the same time enjoy an amazing hotel like what we can offer.
Now, of course, Vietnam is not just about work and business. There is the golf course that you mentioned that envelopes pretty much the property. Mm-hmm. Could you tell us who designed the golf course, and what is it, a challenging golf course? Tell us about it, please.
It's an American company who is behind it, the golf course is unique in the sense that it's, because it sits on a hill, so it's not flat at all. It's quite challenging because it's up and down, it's different angles, and kind of it follows the nature very much. So in terms of that, it's a very challenging golf course. And of course, with the view as well, almost every hole on the golf course, you have somehow a view of the Halong Bay. That was signature hole number 12. You basically, it's a par three, and you basically play with Halong Bay as a backdrop. Golf is something very important for us as a group, FLC. We have our own division, BISCOM, that basically just operates the golf courses. So we manage our own golf courses. We have two more hotels, one in Samsung and one in Kwin Yung, and both have golf courses. And we are now developing quite a lot of hotels in the next 5-6 years, and every single hotel has a golf course and a world championship golf course. So golf is very much, our chairman is a very keen golfer himself, so golf is a very big element of the FLC group.
Now, of course, a lot of people in Asia, they can't play golf all day long. If you're in Thailand, sometimes it can get a bit hot during the day. So it tends to be the morning and late afternoons that you would play. The beauty with Halong, of course, is the weather means you can pretty much play all day long. What time does the golf course open and close?
The golf course is actually floodlit. So you can basically play 24 hours a day. Not that we get requests for tee off at midnight, but basically I would say you normally from 6 o'clock in the morning to 10 o'clock in the evening, you can play the golf course. And a lot of people do that. A lot of people play 36 holes. They come, they play in the morning, they take a break in the afternoon, either enjoy our spa or, you know, we have quite a good spread of F&B outlets here. And then come back and they tee off, say, 6 o'clock, and that's what I normally do. And I get some time. I can tee off at 6 o'clock in the evening and play until 10 o'clock at night. So it's quite unique in that sense.
Now, you mentioned Halong Bay is as one of the wonders of the world. This is a UNESCO World Heritage Site. And when you talk about things such as that, you think of sustainability. In terms of a new property, what are the green credentials of this property? What have you done to ensure that sustainability is a key issue here?
Well, with all the materials that we use, we make sure that sustainability is something very, very important. The chairman himself is very, very specific about it. You can see, even though this is a hotel that's pretty compact, but we make sure landscaping, etc., it's all around there. And sustainability is very much part of the development of the company as well. So, apart from that, I think we're following what everybody else is doing. We obviously are not an international hotel company, but we learn and we see what they're doing and making sure we adapt and making sure that we stay on par with international hotel companies in terms of sustainability.
Now, of course, with Halong Bay, one of the most famous activities is cruising. FLC has the FLC Group has its fingers in a lot of different pots. Do you have your own boat, and is that something that you will be doing so that you can offer people that are staying here a cruise option as well that you control fully?
We have one boat at the moment. We haven't started operating it yet, but the talks are to have our own boats, maybe luxury yachts that we can use, because most of the boats here are pretty similar. They're either very large and they accommodate people so that they can stay overnight, and it's like a floating hotel basically, or you have the smaller ones that just do the normal cruise. What you don't have here are the kind of luxury yachts, which maybe takes, say, 20 people. You can go out and like what you get in Phuket and Samui and say Singapore, etc. So this is something we're looking at, trying to kind of, I think the combination with this luxury hotel and the yachts and, as I said, the MICE business, etc. I think it's pretty obvious that blends itself very well in what we're doing.
Yeah. Vietnam's an up-and-coming destination. It's growing rapidly in terms of visitor arrival numbers, the MICE business, as you said. How would you like to see the government promote MICE business more, especially here in Halong?
I think I would compare pretty much with Thailand. because in terms of the infrastructure and everything, we're pretty similar. Infrastructure is something that's very developed here in Vietnam. Vietnam is very advanced in terms of high tech, IT, etc. It's probably one of the leaders in Southeast Asia. People may not think so, but the infrastructure is very good. Communication is very good. Which I know a lot of the MICE business, when they maybe think of a destination like Vietnam, they would be worried about the connectivity and so forth, but we have that and we are very advanced in that. And as I said, like Thailand, I think Vietnam has scenery and everything, has so much to offer, like Halong. It's not only Halong Bay, but there are a lot of other sites that we can offer, that we can kind of package into as a MICE destination and the golf. So I really believe it's and as I said, the proximity to Hanoi, it's something which I think will also be able to attract MICE business, because they normally they want, especially if it's international, they want 1 or 2 days in a city and then they do the main meeting here, so pre and post, and so close and with so many great hotels in Hanoi. Unfortunately, we don't have an FLC hotel in Hanoi yet, but I think as a MICE destination, and it's very affordable. Vietnam is an affordable country, like you and me just spoke. Thailand is becoming very expensive, for example, even though Thailand is my home, but I can say that in comparison to Thailand, Vietnam is still relatively affordable, and in terms of food and everything, Vietnamese cuisine is becoming world famous. So we can offer that, and in this hotel we got an Italian restaurant, we got a Chinese restaurant, a seafood restaurant. We will have a steak concept up on the rooftop. We got a cigar lounge next to here. So, you know, I think we will be able to really create some very unique packages, and we've seen that here during this ATF. Yesterday we had CNN hosting a lunch. Today we have BBC. We have the outlet. So, you know, it's not like you just have one place. You have one all-day dining. But we can offer a combination of different meal arrangements, etc. So I think we have something quite unique here.
Staffing is an issue. There's so many hotels being built, not just around Vietnam, but throughout ASEAN, the Middle East, Europe, Americas. There's so many hotels coming up. Staffing is an issue for every hotel. Here we are in Halong, a little bit further away from possibly the main areas. Is this an issue for you? And how are you attracting and maintaining and retaining the staff that you need?
For sure, Stephen, it's the biggest challenge anywhere in Vietnam. Vietnam is probably the fastest growing country and destination in Southeast Asia today in terms of hospitality and hotels. The numbers are staggering of hotels coming up here in Halong alone. I think there's 7 or 8 international hotels coming, and that's just what we know today. Probably after ATF, there's a few more, because I know some of the big boys are here scouting around. And human resources, manpower, it's the biggest challenge for us anywhere, and like here in Halong. Vietnam is a relatively virgin country in terms of hospitality. So to really find the workforce, experienced workforce, has been a big challenge for us. I think the fact that we are a Vietnamese company helps us quite a lot. People know FLC Group. We are a well-known household name, I would say. So people enjoy to work for a company that has an association, obviously, with Vietnam. What we also do, we work very closely with, there's a very big university here, Halong University. So we work very closely with them. And at the moment, we have 50 exchange students working with us here. Also Hanoi University, we work very closely with them as well, here and in our sister properties. So I think that's where we get our workforce from. Once other hotels are coming online, certainly it will be a challenge. We're still the only real true five-star luxury hotel, so that kind of helps. And I think for any other hotel, it's the opportunities, it's the training, it's the giving them the best staff canteen, giving them a sense of belonging and so forth. We do a lot of training, we do a lot of that, giving opportunities. So I think and of course salaries is something that in every destination it's always the newcomers. So it certainly will be a challenge to sustain the people, to really keep the people, but I think we, as long as we look after them, I think then hopefully we will be able to keep it up.
And finally, for my last question, if somebody starts thinking about their next MICE destination, their next spot where they're going to take their to hold their meeting or conference, why, if they're looking at Thailand, Singapore, Hong Kong, Indonesia, Malaysia, why should they choose Vietnam, and why should they in particular choose this hotel and how long?
First of all, we have something very unique that I think I mentioned during one of our functions, is that apart from Virgin Airlines with Richard Branson, we're probably the only company in the world, can be that bold to say, that have not only our own hotel group, but we actually got our own airline, which currently the only flight domestically. We just launched it like this hotel a couple of days ago. It's called Bamboo Airways, and we will fly from Saigon and different locations into Halong. So obviously we can package our airline together with the hotel and the other hotels as well, which is something that nobody else can do. If we have a group coming with 150, 200 people and they want something very special, well, it can start the time you take off from Saigon, for example, and we can, we can do things which nobody else can do. So I think that will be one of the one of our main features. And again, I think you mentioned the weather, for example. The weather is like right now, it's like autumn back in Europe, for example. So I think we have a combination of so many things, and exactly what the MICE organizers are looking for, and I think being able to pull off ATF in the way that we've done it, that kind of at least puts a pretty good stamp on what we can do, and this is a new hotel. So if we can organize and successfully do ATF, I think we can probably, with time, we can probably be one of the best MICE hotels in Vietnam, and hopefully in the region as well.
Bamboo Airways will launch flights on the 25th of January, daily flights to Saigon from Vandong, the new airport. Mm. How important is that airport to your future here?
Very, very important. Very, very important. Domestic market. Vietnam's domestic market is very strong, probably one of the strongest in Southeast Asia. The Vietnamese, they travel a lot, especially domestically. And Halong, it's such an important place for the Vietnamese. And now being able to fly from Saigon to here, it's something that they haven't been able to do before. Of course, they can go to Hanoi, and previously, before the highway opened, it would take them almost 20 hours. I mean, you basically fly up to Hanoi, and then from Hanoi with the highway and everything. So people didn't really come. If they came, they came for a few days. Whereas now, they can do the weekend. They can fly on a Friday, morning or afternoon, spend a weekend here and fly back. So right now, obviously, Da Nang, Nha Trang, the beach destination are very strong for the Vietnamese. But a lot of them wants to experience the weather. They want to see Halong Bay, and with again with the golf course and everything, and we have kids facilities. So I think it's going to be a very, very important. It's going to be a very important factor for us, especially as I said, the domestic market is so big. There are very big events like Tet, which is coming around the corner, which is the Lunar New Year. Every hotel in Vietnam are full, 100% full occupancy, and I think we certainly will be able. And you know, the Bamboo Airways offers very good prices. We're very attractive, and we have a very unique concept for that airline. So I think Vietnam Airlines and Vietjet, they have to watch out. I think we will give them a run for their money, for sure.
Excellent. Well, Roland, I have to say thank you very much indeed for your time today. It's great to see you. And of course, I wish you and FLC Grand Halong here the best of luck for the future. Thanks very much.
Thank you very much, Stephen. Always great to have you with us.